car.
Unless he recognized her truck. She does park it where they live. Like this. Whose house are we at? I guess we're at Chloe's house. Two hours in, it's finally daytime. We get the whole day to get through now. Hey, baby. Was it good for you? Couldn't resist. Sure.
Always remember this moment.
Photobomb!
Photo hog.
Hey, now brush your teeth. Smell that.
It feels like a different world from yesterday.
We left a skid mark on Blackwell last night.
Like it needs another one. I'd like to do something good for my school in Arcadia Bay. I can't even submit my photo to represent. I just don't want to be rejected.
Every great artist gets rejected before they get accepted. So you have to enter a photo.
Even though I'm pimping the school and town you want to torch?
Come on, I don't want to see Arcadia Bay burn to the shore. I just say shit like that because I've been trying to get out of here since you left, basically. If I could find Rachel, then pay Frank off, I'm still leaving to start a whole new life.
Wish we could just hang out all morning like we used to. Maybe we should get up. I have to get back to Blackwell soon.
Oh, does the schoolgirl have a test today?
I'm starting to feel like going to Blackwell every day is a test. I just need to get on my regular school schedule again.
I know that it is freezing, but I think we have to walk.
Got to hide in there again? There's a father coming in.
They keep turning their lights off.
I'm so wiped out from last night. But it was awesome.
I have to ponder what kind of criminal I've become.
Last night was only the tip of the iceberg.
I have to admit, it was pretty cool to take over the Blackwell gym.
Today the gym, tomorrow the world. We need to step it up.
We still have to be careful how I use my power. I don't want to get stuck in time.
Ooh, could that happen?
With the sidewalk and the pigeons and my window reflection.
Is it space to get up or something? I wasn't paying attention, I guess. Looks like shit.
I know you have a heavy heart.
Okay, I need to get dressed now.
First I'll look around at everything and check my journal and texts. Glad to see you didn't blow up Blackwell last night. Almost glad. By the way, the drive-in is actually popular, so I'm buying the tickets now. I'll let you take care of the popcorn. In other words, you can't back out now. Talk about being in the Sancto Sanctorum. Thanks, Latin class. I barely passed. of Blackwell, I did feel freaking weird about being in the principal's office after midnight, going through his files and laptop with Chloe. She was way too into it. Technically, we could be arrested and thrown in jail. Yikes. I just pretended that we were on a very special episode of the Wizards of Waverly Place. You know, just a couple of wacky Sherlocks investigating the school for a lost cause. Yeah, that helped. I should go downstairs and eat breakfast. I guess her dad left for work, I guess. While we didn't find the proof, we found Nathan's file had a weird drawing in it that just said Rachel in the dark room over and over. So that's a major clue that Nathan is involved in this somehow. Or he's just insane. But his note also referenced David M., which means that we absolutely have to find a way into David's secret bunker files for a good cause. But Chloe just can't help herself, and she actually wanted to take $5,000 in cash marked handicapped fund, because that's got to be legit, am I right? Oh, maybe not legit? I can't think of a faster route to karma hell, but it would have paid off Chloe's debt to Frank. Okay, so it's legit or not? If it wasn't legit, then I guess there's no bad karma, right? I stopped her, but it kind of bothers me that Chloe can be so selfish like that. I'm not going to let anything happen to her, but I can't just let her do anything she wants. Mad Max? More like Mommy Max. Despite all the usual breaking in and blowing up office hijinks, Chloe decided that we needed more than anything was to take a night swim in the otter's lair. I was so giddy and rebellious that I was like, oh yes, we shall swim. We didn't completely skinny dip, but close enough to get in big trouble no matter what. I don't know why we were so careless after being so careful. I love that Chloe brings out the just don't give a bleep side of me, even if that hasn't always served her well. She deserved a good moment. She deserved a moment of not giving a shit. Me too. Just two friends goofing around the pool. I fear those youthful shenanigans might soon be a thing of our past. God, I'm starting to sound like one of the teachers at Blackwell. Chloe and I had a nice chat about our lives since I left. We talked about dumb boys and girls and why they're trouble. Especially for me. I feel like a groupie when I talk to Chloe about our life experience. She has me so beat. I take pictures. She takes action. Speaking of action, we had to seriously bounce when security showed up. Duh. How quiet could we be in the swimming pool? Plus, after leaving a trail of our Blackwell handiwork. It was so intense and exciting to get past the security guards. They had serious spotlight power, so it wasn't exactly easy to stealth our way past, especially as we had to bail in Chloe's junker. But like I said, intense and exciting. Hella like Chloe Price.
I don't think I'll be moshing today.
Clothes in there, but let's look around first.
Wow. I remember this old phone. We decorated it together. The fact that she put the photo next to Rachel's is so touching.
Don't be a dummy, cover your willy. What's so easy in the evening by the
morning, such a wow, sir. That was my 10th birthday. I didn't know Chloe kept this stuff.
You do now.
I love this song. Can I check out the news on this old laptop?
Why not?
At least we haven't been identified. Yet.
Incident. Police and fire departments responded to a break-in and vandalism on the Blackwell Academy campus around 1:30 a.m. Police have not stated they have any suspects yet. Incident. Police arrested a nude man with a sword at Up All Night Donuts off Peckinpah Road at approximately 8:52 p.m. The unidentified man was charged with being under the influence of energy drinks and methamphetamines. He is being held without bail pending further investigation. Wonder who the hell that was.
I have to go. Especially since Kate's parents aren't going to bury her here.
Funeral for Blackwell's student. A local service will be held on 2 p.m. Saturday, October 12th for Kate Marsh, 18, who died on Tuesday. The family asked for donations sent to her church group care of Blackwell Academy. They plan a private service and burial at another location.
Chloe is so damn cute. She's really trying to suss out what my vision means.
Mystic weather, supernatural science. A joint.
I'm lucky David didn't bust me for acting like it was my pot.
Oh, there's our clothes.
I thought Chloe might put up a pic of me instead. Can't compete with Rachel.
Yeah, Chloe's the one who gets jealous of us talking to somebody else.
Holy shitballs. Frank is scary. I should have let Chloe take that money.
Chloe, money, now. I don't have your money yet. This is my last message. I'll get it. Now, you bleeping whore. Sheesh.
Chloe doesn't seem too upset she didn't take that money from the handicapped fund.
We're gonna have to help her out more next time whenever that comes up.
I love this morning light. It's so peaceful.
Wouldn't it be wicked if we could just hang out here forever like when we were kids?
Yes.
Yes, but sadly we're not kids anymore.
At least you can date now, right? My dad was terrified of the day I would discover boys.
Did you have a boyfriend?
So, you never really told me if you had a serious boyfriend while I was away.
Not serious. Hella stupid, usually. I went through a boy toy phase. Among other things.
I can't see you with other things guys around here.
Because you have a good eye. That's why I was so glad Rachel came along to rescue me.
Oh, really? Seriously? You know, I've been wondering this, but I haven't wanted to bring it up. I think I did once or twice, jokingly. You crushed on Rachel?
Sounds like you totally crushed on Rachel.
You would have, too. Smart, sexy, and sassy. Like me, right?
Hey.
Maybe Rachel would have fought over both of us.
You wish. Then again, maybe. You're a photographer, and she wanted to be a model.
Interesting, gotta say that. Interesting.
Man, if I had stayed hidden, David wouldn't be targeting me.
Yeah, and then Chloe would be in more trouble than she is now. What if we try to leave without getting dressed?
Put some clothes on first, hillbilly.
Yeah, I really have been wondering that.
Time to put on your daily armor, Max.
Armor class plus two.
Ugh. Still reeks like a chlorine factory.
Well, are we the same size?
Find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
Yeah.
If you want, go ahead and check out the closet for some fresh clothes.
Man, if I had stayed hidden... Okay, time for some Chloe cosplay.
Hey, there you go. Rachel left a bunch of her clothes with me. She's your size.
But not quite my style.
Max, you don't have a style yet. At least give it a try. You can always rewind back to your chlorine brand t-shirt and generic jeans.
You suck. I like my shirt and jeans. But it would be cool to try on Rachel's clothes just to see if they fit.
Stop second-guessing yourself, Max. Put this on and let your inner punk rock girl come out. You can afford to take chances whenever and whatever you want to try. For example, I dare you to kiss me.
What?
Hey.
I double dare you. Kiss me now.
Yeah.
Damn. Hey. You're hardcore, Max. Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance.
Don't back up.
Girl on girl action.
You're such a dork.
Oh,
Man, that was priceless when I kissed Chloe. She didn't think I would.
Yeah, she didn't kiss us back. Just want to see what happens if we don't. What would Chloe's reaction be then? Would she be upset that we didn't?
See if you can find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
Okay.
Let's see if we don't.
Sorry, not that easy.
Oh, like I am? Just admit that you already macked on me, then used your rewind. Now I can just mourn that you're saving yourself all for him.
I am so going to best unfriend you for that. I love that Chloe is so fearless.
That's so funny, though. I mean, she wouldn't have asked us if she didn't at least kind of want us to, right? So I'm gonna leave that in the story. Curious to see where that would go.
If you can find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
Okay. Time.
Such a little peck, though, the way she backs off like that. My god.
Damn. You're hardcore, Max.
Hardcore.
Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance. Unless he's into girl-on-girl action.
You're such a dork.
The tension. The tension here. Alright.
I think Rachel's style is a little more subtle. Like me.
We weren't subtle just then. So funny that she guessed we kissed her and then rewound it. Guess right. Really curious to see how many
Looking
people kissed
sick,
her.
Max? A couple tats, some piercings, and we'll make a thrasher out of you yet.
Ready for the mosh pit, Shaka Bra.
Maybe not. Go on down and say hi to Joyce. Free breakfast.
Damn.
I have to wake and bake first.
I promise not to tell.
Let's not rewind and find out, okay? Check you out, Max. Ready for the runway. Go downstairs and show Joyce. She'll love it.
Oh my god. That smells so amazing. It's like when we were kids here.
Yeah, but, something is interrupting our happy time because we've got another unknown message, which is probably me threatening. Oh, well, that's nice of him. Miss Caulfield, I want to thank you so much for your actions with my daughter, Kate. You showed true grace and bravery when you went up to that roof with her. You must know you did all that was possible and that Kate's life was never in your hands, or even hers at that point. Kate has left us for another world, but she'll always be with us, and I know she wants you to have a long, dynamic, blessed life. Our family will include you in our prayers. Peace and joy, Richard Marsh. Oh, so sad. Keep getting sad times. See, it's sad times here. Look around before we go down. There's that bird we let in.
No way. That's the bluebird I saved Monday in Joyce's room.
It's still in here?
Chloe has had this damn dirty pirate towel since we were kids. Serious flashback. Feels so good to wash my face after all that chlorine. And hiding.
And hiding.
Chloe never used to care when I borrowed her toothbrush.
Really?
What's ironic is I always hated it when Chloe used my toothbrush.
Huh. That's funny. That bird.
You know, I haven't gone through a dyeing my hair blue phase yet. Maybe it's time.
Maybe we should go green. Or turquoise.
Check out Mad Max. Ready to fucking thrash. I'm so hardcore.
Two picks. Oh, three actually. Oh, we could have taken a picture of the thing on the principal's desk. Guess we missed one already.
Nobody in this town has a fucking clue as to what's happening. Do they?
I don't think they do.
For everybody else in the neighborhood, it's just another morning. I better not go in there. David might be in bed. Ew.
Oh. Why isn't he at work? Isn't school open at 8 in the morning? I mean, I guess we don't have class yet, but that doesn't mean they're not open.
This might be the one time these people are right.
Nah. The end is now. Are you still ignoring his warnings? Did you feel the snow? Witnessed the eclipse? Seen the dying animals? Dying animals. The signs are upon you. Arcadia Bay is the final battleground for Pazuzu? That is a different faith than Christianity. But behold, the Lord will come in fire, and his chariots like the whirlwind to render his anger with fury, and his rebuke with flames of fire, for his Lord will execute judgment by fire. Let me guess, is something about fire? It has something to do with fire. Let's see our journal. Okay. Even though my body smelled like I had been doused in chlorine, it was so nice to crash in Chloe's room for the first time in 5 years and wake up next to her like our old sleepovers. For some reason, it reminded me of the time we were going to TP one of the neighbor's houses, and we even snuck out but got chicken and ran back home laughing all the way. I remember waking up the next day and Joyce was making one of her delish breakfasts downstairs, and Chloe smiled at me like we were in the most secret club in the world, or at least Arcadia Bay. We were pirates, dammit. After our academic espionage last night, I felt the same way. It's just that now the stakes are much higher and much more dangerous. I even ended up in some of Rachel Amber's clothes since mine were trashed. A band tee and ripped jeans, so not me. But I haven't found my style yet, so why not have fun experimenting with a new outfit? Speaking of experiments, Chloe dared me to kiss her, so I did. She probably thought I'd wuss out. Why? It wasn't that big of a deal. Though it was cute the way she was kind of embarrassed after and said she would tell Warren. Besides, I think Chloe sees Rachel Amber in her future. I just hope Rachel Amber has a future. We'll go in there next. First we'll check their answering machine.
Looks like a message.
David, this is Officer Korn. Just want to let you know, your stepdaughter's car was identified near the Blackwell campus last night, around the time of the break-ins.
What?
Give me a call soon.
Are you in trouble again, Chloe? Don't you sleep?
Well, of course she heard it.
Goodbye, message. I think Chloe has earned a break from all this bullshit.
That was naughty. Told you we gotta help her out. Can we go outside again?
Who drinks beer this early around here?
David.
Kate's life was sure worth a nice exploitive headline.
Flash show and freak eclipse apocalypse soon. Stick around out here before we talk to Joyce. Whippoorwill, whippoorwill. Oh, dead bird.
Oh, dead bird. Poor thing.
Another dead bird. What?
I wonder how these birds died.
Were they trying to get at the other bird who was inside the house? Smash, they fly into the window?
Sitting in a swing always feels so comforting.
So begin the comfort.
I remember when Chloe and me would take turns in the swing. We would push each other so hard we'd fly way up in the air. Chloe always wanted to swing all the way around. I always got scared and would jump off before I flew off. And Chloe is still trying to get high.
Okay. More dead birds. You go in there.
Three dead birds lined up? That's fucking ominous.
Especially if the other two you found. So this is what's going on with the animals now that the leaflet was talking about. Or whatever that was.
I keep expecting to see the sky turn red.
You haven't said a word to this lady.
Wowzer. Chloe still eats the same cereal. So do I.
I love that they still have the same refrigerator.
What we got? Just cereals, no brand names.
Joyce looks so different in her street clothes.
Good morning, Joyce.
Rachel. Max. Oh, you startled me.
Rachel.
You fit those clothes well.
Yeah, okay, clothes on.
I'm not a hellraiser like her or Chloe. Now tell me exactly what you want to chow on.
Eggs and bacon, all the way.
Eggs and bacon all the way.
What?
Remember when you guys would sleep in until I yelled
okay,
out,
that's too funny.
Bakey, eggs and bakey.
Totally. We'd wake up so fast.
So this time you can help me with the ingredients. I need you to grab me the actual eggs and the bacon.
I can handle eggs and bacon.
Eggs and bacon all the way.
Come on, Max. Find those ingredients so we can chow down.
Chow down.
The eggs always come first, as Joyce used to say.
So funny. In the fridge, bacon?
I should evolve and become a vegan, but... Huh, bacon.
Yeah, really. It's one of the few things that stops me, actually.
Thanks. After all these years and everything that's happened, it's great to see you and Chloe together again. She hasn't had a good friend since you or Rachel. Oh, those clothes remind me so much of her. Such a sweet girl. I'm just hoping she's living large in L.A.
I'd love to think that too, Joyce.
She's in L.A.?
We are on the same page, Max. I keep hoping that Rachel will show up or even send a message to Chloe from Hollywood. Or wherever she is.
Was Rachel mad at Chloe?
Is there any reason that Rachel might be mad at Chloe and left without her?
Chloe could piss everybody off but her. They were almost joined at the head. Reminded me of you and Chloe. Rachel wasn't as grounded as you.
I'm grounded? Since when?
I'm surprised she said that.
Maybe that's why Chloe likes Rachel so much.
Max Caulfield, are you actually jealous of Rachel?
Maybe.
Maybe. Rachel was so much cooler than me.
You think? Then why has Chloe been telling me she wishes she could be more like you over the past 5 years?
Doubt it. Did she really?
Doubt it,
5 years ago feels like 1,000 now.
And that makes me, what, a century old? You're only 18, Max. Oh, youth. If only I could go back.
It's not all that, Joyce.
Voila. Breakfast fit for us queens. And a king. Go sit at the table.
Joyce looks so different in her street clothes.
Go on, grab a seat, Max. I'm almost done whipping up this amazing breakfast.
Sure. Peanut butter.
I'm glad that's creamy and not crunchy. Thank you so much, Joyce. I'm never leaving this table.
Good, you can clean.
How am I gonna clean if I'm never gonna leave the table? You gonna bring me all the supplies?
I guess nobody waters the plant here. Bring those eggs and bacon to my belly.
Enjoy, Max. Would be even better, over light and easy with some toast. I guess we didn't eat. We didn't finish eating. Eat that.
You love some bacon. Ah, maybe you remember so much. I know these photos don't measure up to your work, Max.
My favorite photographers probably take pictures similar to yours. You make David happy, Joyce.
He wants us all to be happy, Max. He's just not great at showing it.
I don't think I can rock this outfit like Rachel.
You have your own cool style.
Wowzer. I totally remember that day.
I'm glad. William took this picture with his instant camera. Oh, it was the last picture he ever took. He had his car out right after this. And
The accident.
I know, Joyce. I'm sorry.
I didn't show you this to be morbid. In fact, I want you to have this.
Morbid?
This was when my baby was so full of life and light. She was hopeful, positive. Everything she's not today. And this was the last time I ever saw Chloe truly happy.
Did you guys have a bonding session about how fucked up I am?
It's not always about you.
Chloe, please. It's too early to start picking a fight. Eat instead.
I'll keep the warden busy while you go peek in the garage.
Now stop whispering, or I'll know you're talking about me.
Stop being so nosy, Mother. Jeez, I can't do anything around here without everybody getting up in my shit.
No one can even joke with you, Chloe. You fly off the handle like that.
Excuse me. I have to use the bathroom.
Sure, run off and pee when you should back me up.
Now who's being paranoid? Just listen to yourself.
Nobody else does.
Well, I guess she's doing that to distract her, but I'm like,
I do need to get into David's computer. He's gotta be hiding shit.